Everyone, now let us discuss about sulfation. So the combination with sulfate is a common pathway of metabolism of phenols, but also occurs for alcohols, amines, and to a lesser extent in case of thiols. Sulfation is similar to glucuronation, but it is catalyzed by non-microsomal enzymes and occurs less commonly as the moiety that transfers the sulfate to substrate is easily depleted. And the process is easily saturable in comparison to glucuronidation. And one more difference is sulfation is dominant at low substrate concentrations and glucuronidation is dominant at high substrate concentrations. And the basic sulfation process occurs in two steps. The step one is synthesis of activated coenzyme 3-phosphoadenosine-5-phosphosulfate, PAPS, PAPS. Step one is the synthesis of PAPS, and step two is the transfer of sulfate group from PAPS to the substrate RXH in the presence of enzyme sulfotransferase or sulfokinase, and subsequent liberation of 3-phosphoadenosine-5-phosphate. Now, coming to the synthesis of PAPS, it also occurs in two steps. Step one is an initial interaction between sulfate and adenosine triphosphate, ATP, to yield adenosine-5-phosphosulfate, APS. The second step is activation of APS, which is nothing but adenosine-5-phosphosulfate, to PAPS. Now, coming to the functional groups that are capable of undergoing sulfation. Majorly, the functional groups such as phenols, alcohols, aryl amines, and aryl amides, they undergo sulfation conjugation. Coming to the examples of drugs that undergo sulfation, as we have discussed, phenols undergo sulfation. Example are paracetamol and salbutamol. When it comes to alcohol, the example is aliphatic alcohols from C1 to C5. Next, aryl amines. Example of aryl amines which undergo sulfation are aniline. One more important point is the sulfur conjugates can be tissue reactive, especially O sulfate conjugate of N-hydroxyphenacetin. It covalently binds to hepatic and renal tissues. And in addition to that, several endogenous substances such as steroids and biological amines can undergo sulfation. One more important point is the phenol, alcohol, and aryl amine transferases. Phenol, alcohol, and aryl amine transferases are fairly non-specific and they metabolize a wide range of drugs and xenobiotics. But the steroid sulfotransferases are specific for a single steroid or number of steroids of a particular type. And next point is the sulfate conjugates are more polar, that is water soluble, and they have high renal clearance. Now, coming to the example, isopropanol, it undergoes sulfation. This is the overall reaction. Isopropanol is a drug which undergoes sulfation, especially at this group. OH group is substituted with sulfate moiety. Let us see the overall mechanism of sulfation. As we have discussed earlier, the sulfation mechanism occurs in two steps. The first step is initial interaction between sulfate and adenosine triphosphate to yield adenosine-5-phosphosulfate. That is nothing but APS. Initial interaction between ATP and sulfate in order to form APS. And the next step is APS It reacts with ATP in the presence of ATP phosphokinase and magnesium ions, and it forms phosphoadenosine 5-phosphosulfate. This is the major donor group. And this reacts with the drug RXH in the presence of sulfotransferase and yields sulfated conjugate RxSO3 plus PAP, which is nothing but phosphoadenosine 5-phosphate. Here X can be O and NH. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for further videos on biopharmaceutics and pharmacokinetics.